The University of Kentucky is participating in a new clinical trial for stroke. The Phase 2 clinical trial includes centers all over the United States. Some centers assess patients. Others perform the surgery, delivering stem cells directly into the brain of individuals who have had a stroke, with the goal of improving motor function. UK is one of the surgical sites.
You have to throw in the controls. You have to do it as a multi-center trial. So I think one of the big challenges in a study like this is that we have to deliver cells to a specific part of the brain. We're actually putting the cells around the area that has been damaged. If we can tap into that potential with the stem cells, allow those cells that are remaining to function better, then patients may be able to regain some of their function.
UK's path to participation in this trial wasn't a straight line. In fact, it was only thanks to the persistence of a chain of people dedicated to collaboration. Dr. Van Horn learned of this trial from his colleague, Dr. Frazier. Then Van Horn brought it to Dr. Quintero.
So I just asked George, said, do you have the capacity to do this? We really wanted to be a part of it for part of our brain restoration center. And we thought it was a really worthwhile trial. George does not say no. So we said, sure, let's give it a try. And he's persistent, and he just finds a way to make it work. It took about 2 years to get to this point, but that's what it takes.
But there's FDA regulations on what type of cell facility it needs to be able to have good cell tissue practices. And so that's not something that's easily found, or there's not a registry for that. Then we sort of stumbled onto looking at maybe bone marrow transplants.
Quintero reached out to Dr. Hildebrandt, Division Chief of Blood and Marrow Transplantation. Hildebrandt connected him to Dr. Roger Herzig and Rita Hill.
We've always been interested in what other properties these cells possess other than just being able to reconstitute blood. These cells can be made to grow into other types of cells and has been used in spinal cord injuries, in hearts that have been damaged. This project is a little bit different, but again, it's using the cells in a novel way. It's just scientifically intriguing.
One of the advantages of having Rita is that she has a lot of expertise in managing cell labs and sort of the requirements for cell processing and the requirements for the FDA.
I first met with Dr. Quintero, and he gave us the protocol to look at, wanted to know if we thought we could handle it here in the lab. We reviewed it, we liked it. Both Dr. Van Horn and Dr. Quintero were very clear in the fact that they wanted to work with us and they would be flexible in the timing because they knew that we were responsible for the BMT patients.
Hill's expertise, specifically the need to validate an instrument to test the stem cells right before they are injected into the patient, led her to suggest a change to the study protocol. That change was implemented nationwide.
I have previously been in, other institutions where that culture does not exist. And, even though you might be on the same team in neurosurgery, there's still a competition and people are not that excited to see you succeed. And they're not so good at sharing, resources or time or ideas. Here, we really just don't have that. And people really want to see other people succeed. And even though, this is stroke work, this is what Justin does, he had no problem saying, what do you think? You do that kind of thing. Would you be interested?
You may have, the kernel of an idea, but to finally execute it, frequently will take the expertise of other people. And to me, that's kind of the exciting part of medicine, is how we get along and how we actually accomplish these things.
All of those departments and all of those people within those areas were very willing to find out a way and not saying, this is just too much, we can't do this, but, oh, that's a great idea, let's figure out a way to make that work. And everybody kind of stepped up and pitched in and made it happen.